People are always looking to identify elusive factors which may result in a lower chance for a live birth from IVF. Sometimes, however, the answer may be something we are already aware of. Recently, scientists undertook a very large study to determine whether a patient's weight might play a role in determining IVF success. What they found might surprise you. Stay tuned. Taller people will often weigh more than shorter people. In order to take that into account, doctors will often use body mass index, or BMI, to study the impact of weight. BMI categories may differ slightly in different countries. A low BMI indicates that a person is underweight. A high BMI, greater than 25, indicates that a person is overweight. A BMI over 30 is defined as obese. There are also different classes of obesity for people who have a BMI over 35, 40, and so on. Subscribers to this channel might remember some previous episodes where I discussed BMI. In this episode, researchers from China looked at people without infertility who were trying to get pregnant on their own without treatment. They found that when women were underweight, they were 3% less likely to become pregnant, and obese women were 9% less likely to become pregnant. If both male and female partners were underweight, they were 10% less likely to become pregnant, and if both were obese, they were 20% less likely to become pregnant. What about couples who are doing IVF? There have been some studies that have attempted to look at this. In order to isolate the impact of weight, we would like to have a study in which the embryos are good quality and as similar as possible. Several years ago, a study looked at the pregnancy rates in couples who were using embryos made with eggs from egg donors. This study showed lower pregnancy rates in obese individuals. Recently, another very large study was conducted using the data from the US IVF registry. They looked at embryo transfers in which the embryos had been tested and shown to have the correct number of chromosomes. This is known as PGT-a. A total of 77,018 PGT-a cycles from 55,888 patients were analyzed. Here's what they found. Using these high-quality tested embryos, the highest pregnancy rates and live birth rates were in women who had a BMI between 23 and 25. The further that women got from that BMI range, the lower their pregnancy rates became. For example, women with a lower BMI saw their chance for pregnancy decrease. When female BMI was between 18.5 and 20, their chance for a live birth was about 7% lower. For BMIs less than 18.5, it was 11% lower. Overweight women saw similar problems. BMIs between 25 and 30 saw a 4% decrease in the live birth rate. 30 to 35 was 9% lower. 35 to 40 was 15% lower. And a BMI over 40 was about 30% lower. Why was the live birth rate lower? There were a few reasons. In very thin women, those with a BMI less than 18.5, there were fewer positive pregnancy tests, meaning that embryos did not implant. For both thin and obese women, the chance for the pregnancy to be lost between a positive blood test and an ultrasound was higher for both thin and obese women. So if this is true, and this data is pretty convincing, then solving the problem should be as easy as gaining weight if you're too thin and losing weight if you're too heavy, right? Well, maybe. So far, studies have not been able to show, for example, that weight loss improves IVF pregnancy rates, but as you can imagine, these studies are pretty hard to do. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.